So we've seen how to use recursive definitions to make words and to define concepts like ancestors. Now we're going to see how to use recursive definitions to define a procedure. And we're going to start with the procedure that we already defined in Unit 2. We defined the factorial procedure, and we defined factorial as the number of ways that we can order n items, and the input is a number n, and that could be calculated by multiplying n times n minus 1 times n minus 2, and so on, until we get down to the 1. So that definition is not very precise mathematically, and the problem with this as a mathematical definition is it's got this dot 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 in it. And humans sort of understand that correctly, what that dot 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 means, but it's not a very precise mathematical definition. If we use a recursive definition, we can define factorial in a much more precise way. And we need to do that by giving a base case. So for the base case, we want to think about the simplest input, something where we already know the answer. And for factorial, and for many procedures that involve numbers, the simplest input is the number 0. So if we try factorial 0, the number of ways to arrange 0 things is defined as 1. So we know that result. That's going to be our base case. Now all we need to do is define the recursive case, where we want to define what the meaning of factorial for any number n is, where n is any integer greater than 0. And we can define that in terms of the factorial of the smaller numbers. So if you look at this definition with the dot, 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 well, we see that the factorial of n is n times n minus 1 and so forth. Well, this, what we have here, is actually the factorial of n minus 1. So that means that we can define the factorial of n as n times the factorial of n minus 1. And that's our recursive case. And this definition matches our intuition well. If we think about factorial meaning the number of ways to arrange n objects, this corresponds exactly to the way we think about this, that we have n ways to pick the first item. And once we pick the first item, well, we have n items left, and factorial of n minus 1 gives us the number of ways to arrange the remaining n minus 1 items. So that's a way to define this mathematically. So now I'll leave it to you as a quiz to figure out how to define a procedure that computes factorial without using a while loop.